looking at me. Facing the mirror is all I need. Wait until the reaper takes my life. Never gonna get me out alive. I will live a thousand million lives.
My patience is waning. Is this entertaining? My patience is waning. Is this entertaining?
What's going on, everyone? The Great Talent here, and today we're going to talk about The Boys, Amazon Prime Video series. Started a few years ago, I forget exactly when, but it took me by storm and the whole country, nation, world by storm, because it, and no pun intended, because Storm's from the X-Men, they have powers in The Boys. It is the most brutally honest, as you can be, show about what happens if superheroes become corrupted by their own fame and success. The type of like politics that goes on behind the scenes and the shit that they get away with because they're just superheroes. It kind of like feels like it is the Game of Thrones of, best way to describe it, Game of Thrones of superhero shows, in my opinion. Because it's just like you don't know who's gonna live, who's gonna die. You know, people getting picked off one by one. Who's dying, who's living, who's coming back, this, and that. And it's just really fucked up. I have never done a review of The Boys season 1 or 2 on my channel, so I'm just going to review season 3 without any spoilers. But I'm going to give a little bit of a backstory on The Boys and how it became so successful and why. Not only because of the amazing performances, but the comic book was very successful. It was written by Robert Kirkman, like the guy who did The Walking Dead. And even though season 3 kind of strays from the comics a little bit in a good way, not a bad way, in a good way. Not like Game of Thrones. It doesn't shit the bed like Game of Thrones, folks. When it runs out of source material, it just like, you know, just fucking takes a big old diarrhea dump on you. No, it doesn't do that, folks. It doesn't do that at all. It actually is quite good. Quite very, very, very good. The first season centers around this superhero named Starlight, who has the powers, like if you've seen Jubilee, she kind of can just make, you know, if she has a light source, she can kind of amplify the light, and she can fly and hover, and she can like blind people. She can like use the light as a power source and kind of just use it as energy and so on and so forth. But and it centers around her, and the first season's kind of like the shit that she thinks it's all lollipops and like gumdrops and rainbows and unicorns when she first gets anointed to join the superhero club. Who are forming like the Avengers, they're called the Justice League, they're calling it the Seven. You have Homelander, who's just a fucking maniac, he's an evil Superman, let's just call him that. Then you have Black Noir, who's just pretty much Black Panther, who's a mute, but he's like super strong or whatever. Then you have Maeve, who's pretty much Wonder Woman, she's really strong. Then you have the Deep, who's Aquaman, or I makes fun of him, he's the whooping boy of the group. Then you have the Flash, who's A-Train, they call him. And Starlight, she's the newest member. Of the Seven, and she's dealing with all this shit, this new shit that's going on that she didn't realize that they get away with on a daily basis, the corruption, the depravity, the debauchery they get away with, and it's just so fucking corrupt. And she's trying to like come to terms with that and like find her place. At the same time, it on the other side of the fence, it centers around a guy named Yui, who's just an average Joe who kind of just has really bad luck. His girlfriend dies right in front of his eyes, and he wants revenge on her and vengeance. So he joins this ragtag group of like people called The Boys, who are just normal average Joe guys who take down soups in meaningful ways. Kind of like Batman. Like, they don't kill. Well, they kill. Sorry, they do kill. I like the Punisher. Think about the Punisher, because they're just like this group of like the Punisher-like people who just go around and kill all these. If murder has to happen to these soups, they do it, the corrupt ones. But Billy Butcher's the leader. Carl Urban, bless his fucking heart, he is the gruffiest-looking guy. He's like the, I want to call him the Australian, I don't know if he's Australian. I think he's Australian or British. I think he's British. The British fucking Punisher, because he just goes around, he doesn't give a fuck, he just goes around doing whatever the fuck he wants, folks. It's like Homelander, like the superhero is just fucking evil and corrupt. But it's a very well made show, very well crafted show, very well written show. And so the whole story and focal point is this: the boys are trying to take down the Seven, the superhero leaders, and their corrupt overlords called Vought International, the corrupt corporation who's actually running the Supes, and they pull their strings behind closed doors. But yeah, so that's the premise of the show. Season one and two were phenomenal. Season three just got even better somehow. I don't know. I don't want to give my hopes up. I like to keep my guard up a lot, but especially after what happened with Game of Thrones, I thought that show was the be all end all. But I'm gonna say it's just very good. I'm gonna remain cautious because I know there's a season four inevitably coming. But season three was a wild ride from start to finish. Don't want to really spoil too much, but just be prepared. Each season tries to, it's kind of like, have you ever seen the show Jackass? You know how in every Jackass movie or episode they try and one-up the last episode or last movie with the most grotesque shit you've ever seen and most fucking mind-blowing shit? That's the boys. Every season they try and they manage to do something more fucked up than the last season to make you go, oh, crikey, like, what the fuck did I just see? So yeah, in terms of gore and shock value and fucking just annihilation. And they achieved that here, tenfold. And one scene in particular that involves a very small superhero going inside a very sensitive part of a human's body and kind of making it go boom, boom, bye-bye, boom goes the dynamite. But yeah, so Boys Season 3, it kind of, I really wish I could spoil things, folks, but I know how you people feel about spoilers, so I could say spoiler tag in the comments below, but then that might not, you know, get people to watch the video, but I really want you to just, in a nutshell, if you like blood, gore, a very unapologetic fucking blood and gore, as well as a very well-crafted and spun story that delves into not only just being flashy gore and violence and just extreme you know, behaviors, but delves into the deep psychological behavior behind behind in the mind of someone or people in general who have these abilities, and how would you feel or how would you act if you had this great power and instead of choosing to have great responsibility, you chose to just do whatever the fuck you want with it? What does it do to your psyche? What does it do to your persona, your behaviors? And it also goes to show you how people, you know, you just spin their webs, and you get to see everything come full circle. Like, things happen in season one and season two that you think a character's out of the game, but they come back and it's like, oh, this is cool. But they don't do it in cheap ways. They do it in well thought out and fleshed out ways is what I'm trying to convey. And I appreciated the show. I mean, when I'm watching this show, I'm in it. I'm not fucking around on my phone. I'm not bored. I'm not like, what am I watching? I mean, I'm saying, what am I watching? But then they're going like, oh my God, what the fuck am I watching? But this is great. The acting, again, is phenomenal. I'll go back, Carl Urban, Anthony Starr. You got a bunch of other folks here. Can't remember their real names, but they do a great job. In and out. I mean, it takes a lot to put on this type of performance and to become this, like, kind of just diabolical, in a sense, because that's what it is. They're all just diabolical, all these superheroes. The vast majority, with the exception of one or two, are diabolical because they have just been so corrupted by their own existence and what they can do. And it's just very, again, it's a very psychologically driven show, in addition to a lot of blood and gore and satisfying moments in that field. But again, I can't say too much more without spoiling it. Just know season three, again, it ended on a cliffhanger where you can kind of see what's going to happen next and what direction they're going to go with in the show. Because and just when you think it's over, it just keeps on going, folks. It just keeps steamrolling and steamrolls you over, and it just keeps on going to the next fucked up thing. And I just can't wait to see what happens next. So if you're a fan of superheroes, nerdy stuff, and just want a little bit more of an edge to it, I would definitely highly recommend this show. Again, this is my first review of it. I'm not going to review season by season. I'm just going to give you a brief overlook of the show. Whenever the series does wrap up, maybe four or five or however many seasons are going, I will then give a full spoiler review of the entire series, breaking it down from start to finish. But for now, just keeping it short and sweet and to the point. And I hope you guys can appreciate that. So yeah, if I had to score The Boys, as a whole, I'm going to do it as a whole, up until this point, seasons 1, 2, and 3, as an aggregated total on a scale of 1 to 10, I'm giving it a 9 out of 10. It's amazing. What's preventing it from me from giving it a 10? It's a little too extreme at times. I don't want to sound like a snowflake or anything, but sometimes it, some of the imagery is not safe for children, or you know what I mean? Like, I mean, child shouldn't be watching the show anyway, a little kid, but you know, it's just, even for as an adult, some of the gore is a little bit like this is meaty. Like, it's a little too realistic at times, and I'm going, holy shit, this is like, oh, I cringeworthy a little bit. But that's, I guess that's good and bad. But other than that, I mean, it's a very, very good show. It's an amazing, phenomenal show, and I can highly recommend it. Another show I want to do a review on is Invincible. Maybe with another season. I think that's coming another season. That show is like an animated version of this, just as fucked up as this show is. And that's the theme of this whole series, is it's just really fucked up. Nobody ever wins. You just do a little better each time. And with that being said, folks, that's my review of The Boys. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll catch everybody next time. Thanks, as always, for stopping by.